The province of Agusanofu is Caraga Region's biggest province. This landlocked province is inhabited by the indigenous groups of Manobo, Higaomen, Aita, Mamaliwa, and Bagobo. Agusanofu is one of the richest provinces in the land of promise, Mindanao. Where nature, history, culture, and modernity abounds. The province was still on the verge of experiencing darkness. Its mission was tested. Natural calamities had it hampered. Economic circumstances had it bewildered. And struggles had it faltered. But none of these have worn it down. Today, it proudly stands with its aspiration for the community and the people with renewed vision, mission, and commitment.
Sigon sa program sa NIA, ang Agusan del Sur 1986 pa i-energize. O among di panginguha na makuha kin matalanta sa sayo na pag-energize sa atong Agusan Sur. So, ang remedyo among giadtuan si First Lady Madam Imelda Romualdez Marcos na siya may chairman of the board sa Comang Electric Cooperative. Naghangyo ko nga, ma'am, kung 1986 pa, katugay na niya na tuig pa nga among huwatan na karon nagsige na daghan ang mga negosyante sa Agusan Sur. So, si ma'am ni Sulting adtoa si Colonel Domol na maoy executive manager sa NIA. Ni-schedule onsa ang unsay pangabuhaton. Una sa tanan, wala man tay puhunan. So, ang board nag-agree na mo huwam sa cooperative, sa allocation sa National Electrification Administration. So, gitagaan kami og 10 million para sa pagsugod gid sa atong cooperative. Giubanan gid sa members sa Board of Directors, uban ang atong DILD nga si Nanding Robles, Fernando Robles. Og kami niyang duha nagtimbang para gid mahatagan og early energization sa Agusan Sur. Na-energize sa 1981 ang atong Agusan Sur.
Former Governor Madam Valentina Luling Plaza plays vital roles in the full realization of rural electrification program in Agusan del Sur, which resulted to social transformation and economic development. The National Electrification Administration, or NEA, formed and organized under Presidential Decree No. 269, is one of the government's owned and controlled corporation or agency tasked to give support and supervision and provide technical, institutional, and financial assistance to all electric cooperatives in the Philippines. Thus, the loan contract was with an amount of 9,580,000 pesos was signed in Quezon City, Manila on February 23-24, 1978.
When I was assigned as acting general manager of ASELCO in 1978, I had only one clear marching order from the administrator. That was to electrify as early as possible all the towns of Agusan del Sur. We requested for a task force to construct a tie line between Daneco and Trento. In a year's time, Trento was energized. After that, we also constructed a line going to Santa Josefa. So Santa Josefa was also energized a year after. And then the towns of Bayugan, Prosperidad, San Francisco, and Sibagat. And the last town that we energized was the town of La Paz and Loreto, which we find hard to bring the poles to the area. Ang among gibuhat niya, among gipaagi ang poste gikan sa Punawan, gimotor sa agi sa Agusan River, pag-abot sa La Paz ug Loreto, atong gibalsa padong sa atong linya. Unya ang pinakalisod nga nahitabo pag-construct ani nga mga area kay wala may daan, baktas ang atong mga layman. But tanan ni nahimo nato tungod sa pagtinabangay sa lokal natong officials ug sa inyong kooperatiba. Kini usab nahitabo tungod sa suporta sa ubang mga kooperatiba.
In August 26, 1977, the Agusan del Sur Electric Cooperative Incorporated, or ASELCO, was formally organized and registered with the NIA with Certificate of Registration Number 91 at Patinay Prosperidad, Agusan del Sur. As mandated by law, ASELCO executes its main function in the spirit of missionary electrification program pursuant to the newly promulgated law, the Republic Act 10531, or the National Electrification Administration Reform Act of 2013, further amending Presidential Decree 269, or the National Electrification Decree. ASELCO is a non-stock, non-profit, members-owned electric cooperative mandated by law to find ways and bring reliable, affordable, and reasonable cost of electricity to every home in Agusan del Sur. Finally, within a period of 4 years, all municipalities, namely Sibagat, Esperanza, Bayugan, San Luis, Talacogon, Prosperidad, San Francisco, Rosario, Bunawan, Trento, Santa Josefa, Veruela, Loreto, and La Paz were connected to the Mindanao grid, causing the energization of thousands of households, which consequently led to the energization of 315 barangays in the entire province. More than 2 decades after electrification of the province of Agusan del Sur became a dream come true, the economic landscape of the entire province transcends, and people's lives in communities transform. From ASELCO's humble beginning, number of member consumers and connections seems to grow in numbers exponentially.
Ang ni sign up mga member consumers is mga kuan na to 22,000 na sa akong time. Marag paspas ang kampanya na magbayan sa membership education. Kaya importante na nga ma-edukar ang mga consumer para at least kamahibaw sila sa mga malisiya sama sa up-to-date sa pagbayad sa atong bill para ma-maintain nato ang discount sa NPC.
One major factor in rapid growth of ASELCO's membership and household connection is undoubtedly attributed due to population growth, industrial development, employment growth, and socio-economic development. ASELCO serves its valued member consumers owners by distributing power generated from different power plants in Mindanao, which runs through substation lines, reduced into lower voltage through a Selco power substation transformers. These power substation transformers convert electricity channeled through line feeders that runs through power lines going to different municipalities, barangays, sitios, and porongs. Our substations are upgraded regularly as number of end users grew each year.
A lot of barangays, parplang barangays, and some sitios were provided with electricity, and also some industrial consumers of Selco. Selco was consistently declared by the National Electrification Administration. We were classified from large to extra large. Then we were also consistently categorized as E-plus cooperative for the past, siguro mga 7 years. However, my greatest legacy that I left Selco was the installation of the 50 MVA substation in Alegria that is owned by the NGCP, then the Transco before. Wala pa kasi tayong 50 MVA dito sa Agusan del Sur. So it will a big boost to the electrification industry in Agusan del Sur. And aside from that, this will also boost the opportunity that investors from other parts of the country will put their capital in Agusan del Sur because of the presence of that 50 MVA substation.
Apart from its main thrust of providing reliable, reasonable, and customer-friendly services, Selco strengthens its social engagement and partnership by extending its program through the institutionalization of its corporate social responsibility, expressed in various forms of charitable activities to the community. Selco's corporate social responsibility is both a statement and commitment for excellent service. The present economic landscape of the interprovince of Agusan del Sur is a work in progress, brought about by the advent of missionary rural electrification that Selco started.
ako isipin yung tagdumala sa kooperatiba, maghahangyo sa makanunayan yung suporta, sa makanunayan yung pag-abang gato sa atong kooperatiba. Aron nga ang tanan natong mga plano, mga panglantaw, atong yung matuman o mapaabot gato sa mga katawan, gato sa mga membro konsumador. Nakatuto kita nga dili lang sa paglampo sa atong pinansyal na aspeto. Apil usap niya na atong itutukan karon ang paglambo isip nga maayong membro, maayong tao sa komunidad, maayong lumulupyo, kung maayong agusano. Sa natong tanan, dagang salamat sa inyong suporta o God bless us all.